Hello everyone, namaskar. So today we are going to solve one problem which is from application of partial differential equation, and it says using the method of separation of variables, it's a method, solve del u by del x equals to 2 del u by del t plus u, and where they have given that the value of u at x comma 0 is 6 e power minus 3x. It's an interesting method. So let's see how to solve problems using this method. So in this type of problems, we assume our solution. Now, from the given equation, you can say that the dependent variable is u and independent variable is x and t. So u is a function of x and t. So assume the solution to be, now as I told you, u is a function of x and t. So we are assuming that the solution looks something like this. X we are taking, which is a function of x only, and we are taking t, which is a function of t only. So I am saying that my solution will be u equals to x into t, where x is a function of capital X, small x only, and t is a function of small t only. Okay. So let's see. So what I will be doing next is, you can write that capital X is a function of small x only and capital T is a function of small t only. And I am writing also. So capital X is a function of and capital T is a function of . So if we take this, which was given as equation number 1, and this as equation number 2, so I am saying differentiate equation number 2 with respect to x. Partially, so partial derivative of u with respect to x can be written as del u by del x. Now, because as I told you that capital X is a function of x only, so instead of writing del x by del x, that means del capital X by del small x, I can also write dx, because I know that that capital X is a function of x only. So no need to use that partial notation, and this t will remain as it is. Fine. Let's mark this as equation number 3. Okay. Now, again, I will say that differentiate equation number 2 with respect to this time t partially, so you will get del u by del t. Same story will repeat. T is a function of small t only, so instead of partial notation I can write like this also, and capital X will remain as it is because that is in product. So equation number 4, from 2, 3 from 1, 3 and 4. So basically I will be using the value of del u by del x and del u by del t from equation 3 and 4 in equation number 1. So del u by del x is dx by dx times t equals to 2 times del u by del t is dt by dt times capital X plus u is nothing but capital X times capital T. What I am doing is dividing throughout by xt. What I will get in the LHS, t will get cancelled because t by xt, so t will get cancelled. So I will get dx by dx. Along with that, I had t which got cancelled, and I was left with 1 by x. And in RHS, x will get cancelled from the first term. I will get 2 dt by dt. Into 1 by t. And from the third term xt, that will now become 1. And this 2 I am supposing to be equal to some constant, let's say k. Now one by one I will equate this to k and solve. So first I am equating the first one, which is dx by dx into 1 by x to k. Let's separate variables, so I can write this as dx by capital X equals to k dx. If I integrate both sides, so dx by x will give me log x equals to kx plus constant, which I am writing as log c1. So I can now say that log of x minus log of c1 is equal to kx. So log of x by c1 is your kx. If I assume log base to be e, so x by c1 will be e power kx. So x is equal to c1 e power kx. Assume this to be equation number 5. Similarly, from the second one and k, so 2 dt by dt. Into 1 by t plus 1. dt by dt into 1 by t equals to k minus 1. Fine. So what I am doing is 2 dt by t equals to k minus 1 times dt. Again, integrate both sides. Integral of dt by t will be log t. K minus 1 times t plus log c2. First of all, by the property of log, this will jump to the power. So I will get log of t square is equal to k minus 1 times t plus log of c2. So log of t square minus log of c2 is equal to k minus 1 times t. So I will get log a minus log b is log a by b. T square by c2 is equal to e power k minus 1 t. So you are getting t square equal to c2 e power k minus 1 times t. If I take square root, so t is under root c2, and square root means power half, so e power k minus 1 t divided by 2. Now root c2 I can take as another constant, let's say c3. Now I know my solution, let's mark this as equation number 6. So from equation number 2, the recent equation 5 and 6. From 2 it was u equals to x times t. So u equals to what is your x? Your x is c1 e power kx. And your t is c3 e power k minus 1 t by 2. I can combine this and write as c1 c3 e power will add, so kx plus k minus 1 t divided by 2. Let's mark this as equation number 7. Now in order to find the value of c1 c3 and t k, because these are our assumptions, some other student would have taken something as assumption. So because we don't clash, so we need to remove this. Okay, how to remove? With the help of initial condition, which is given as at x equals to x and t equals to 0, value of u is given as 6 e power minus 3x. Okay. So put t equals to 0 in equation number 7. So you are getting u as 6 e power minus 3x given in the question. And from equation number 7, you are getting as c1, c3. This entire term will become 0 because k minus 1 times 0. You are only left with e power kx. Now if I equate them, I am getting c1 c3 to be equal to 6 and my k to be equal to minus 3. So keeping putting back this value in equation number 7, you are getting u as c1 c3 is 6 e power kx, so k is minus 3x plus k minus 1 by 2, minus 3 minus 1, minus 4 by 2, that means minus 2t. So this is what we are getting. Moreover, if you want, you can do something like this, 6 e power minus you can take common 3x plus 2. This is your final value. So again, interesting one. What we did, let's revise that. From the starting, we assumed u to be function of, u was already a function of x and t. We took that equal to capital X, which is function of x only, multiplied by capital T, which is a function of t only. Differentiate equation 2, first with respect to x partially, then with respect to t partially. We got some equation, put that back in the original equation, equate both of them to be equal to k, solve them, get the value of x and the value of t, capital X and capital T. Now you know u equal to capital X into capital T, put them back, put back the value of your constant, find the value of your constant, because they were your constant, not universal. So you have to put their value back, which was c1, c3 and k. So if you put that back, you get your final solution. That's it from my side. For more such questions, subscribe to my channel. Thanks and have a nice day.